Despite what I said before, I will need to break my schedule. Time has been an issue, and I have yet to finish the Socrates videos. To finish them, I want to collect all sorts of sources and data so that you can understand completely what this man and the Socialist Party have been doing to Portugal. Since I still don't have everything I need, I will need to put those videos on hold. However, a lot has been happening in Portugal, and I already talked about a few of them in my Gab account, which I hope you can follow. The link is in the description. But I really wanted to do a video about them, and specifically about one event, which is, of course, related with the left and far-left government, and specifically the socialists in that government. Augusto Santos Silva is the number two in government. Essentially, if António Costa, the current prime minister, has some sort of issue, he is ill, he cannot attend a meeting, Augusto Santos Silva will be his replacement. He is the number two in government. I already talked about the cases of nepotism with this government. They have reached a level never before seen. Never in this country we've seen a government employ so many family members of other people in government. It's outrageous. And of course, it raises eyebrows to everyone, but in Portugal nothing happens because this is a dictatorship, essentially. And whoever is in power does whatever they want. The taxpayer just has to pay taxes, and that's it. However, we do have laws, and one law specifically prevents people in government from doing business with friends or family members. If they are in government, they cannot do them. But if they do, then the law states that whoever is in government that actually do those sorts of deals with friends or family members, then they need to be fired. Recently, Augusto Santos Silva, again, the number two in government, said that it would be absurd to interpret that law literally. And why did he say this? Because we found that many people in government are actually doing business with friends and family members with taxpayer money, essentially. According to the law, they should be fired. However, Augusto Santos Silva says that, what? A law being interpreted literally? No way! That is absurd! That's right. A law, according to this man, this criminal, essentially that's what he is, should not be interpreted literally. So what is a law exactly? A law is precisely something that should be interpreted literally, because it sets in stone the consequences for breaking that law. The law relates to murder, for example. The law relates to rape, for example. The law relates to stealing, for example. And all those laws will have consequences for someone that rapes someone else, for someone that kills someone else. You need to interpret it literally, because that's what the law is, but not in Portugal. If you are part of the government, of course, and especially the left and far left, then you can do pretty much anything, because you can interpret the law as you see fit. It's subjective. No one has been fired from the government. And in fact, the Prime Minister himself asked the district attorney to give them an advice on the law. And one of the best parts is actually the fact that this specific law was changed by António Costa in 1996. So he's asking the district attorney to tell him about the law that he changed. Obviously, this is just a scam, another scam of the Socialist Party, because they have no intention of following the law that they know they changed. They know they made this law. But the laws in Portugal are made for one objective only. They pay millions and millions of euros to attorney offices to write those laws, and of course those attorneys are from the Socialist Party, or someone on the left or the far left, whoever. They get those millions of euros. The law is put into practice, it is in some sort of textbook somewhere, but it will never be followed. The laws in Portugal are in fact optional for whoever is in power. They don't need to follow them, they are subjective. But please don't think that laws in Portugal are optional for everyone, of course not. They are only optional for whoever is in power and the groups that are somehow connected to those people in power. And of course the left and the far left, they also benefit from these optional laws. They don't need to follow them. Because the media, they might report these cases, but they don't really do any sort of pressure. They don't make sure that people know about the things that the government is doing. The media in Portugal is completely controlled by the left and the far left. Again, they will report these things, but it's something mild, and it will quickly disappear from the front page of the newspaper, and it will be barely mentioned in any news piece on the TV. And because the memory of the Portuguese people is so poor, no one will remember this in a few weeks. Or they will make sure that an existing issue is created to be something much bigger than it actually is, so that everyone else forgets about these things that the government has done, the laws that are broken, the laws that are not to be interpreted literally. And that is what happened in the past couple of weeks with the strike of the truck drivers. The truck drivers are working for the private sector, of course, and they have miserable conditions. We are talking about 630 euros of base salary. They get more money, but the base salary is 630 euros. The rest of the money comes from either bonuses or extra hours that they worked, stuff like that. But the base salary is very, very low, and this is what counts for the retirement pension. And so these people will have very, very poor retirement pensions, even though they've worked many more hours than many other people in this country. And so what the government has done, when all the scandal about these dealings that were being done by people in government with their friends or family members, they made sure that the strike of the truck drivers was a much bigger problem than it actually was. The government actually created panic around the strike, which made lots of people run around to supermarkets to buy products as if the world was going to end on the next day. People going to pharmacies and buying all sorts of medicine because they thought that they would not have medicine in the next day. The government created that panic. Why? Simple. Because they wanted to hide everything about the nepotism and all the shady deals that they are making with the taxpayer money. And at the same time, just to show you how ridiculous this country is, at the same time, the president was passing a law, because in Portugal the president is pretty much useless. He only has the power to fire the government, but this guy currently in office as the president, he will never do that because he is a doofus, he is an idiot, and he is completely aligned with the left and far left government, even though he is from a center-left party, which is even more ridiculous. But that's what he is. He will never fire this government. That's the only power he has, but he will never fire this government. But the president also needs to, you know, give his signature to a certain law. And while the truck drivers were on strike to get a better salary than what they are getting right now, and their very, very poor base salary of 630 euros, the president was passing a law that will raise the salary of judges up to 700 euros. Judges in Portugal are some of the most privileged people in this country. They have extremely high salary. And if you've seen my previous videos about the justice system, you will understand that the justice system in Portugal is completely broken. Nothing works. And of course, the judges are partially to blame for it. They are not entirely to blame, but they have a lot of blame for that fact, because they do nothing. They get a lot of money for the little work that they do, and because they do such little work, the justice system is slow and barely works. So they are getting a raise of up to 700 euros, while people with horrible conditions in their line of work that have a base salary of 630 euros are being pressured by the government to stop the strike. And essentially the government went against the right to strike of these people. So Portugal is a dictatorship. There's no other word. There's no other place where laws are subjective other than a dictatorship. There's no other place where rights are only applied to the group of people that whoever is in power decides that they should have those rights. Although we do have laws and rules that state that these rights are to be given to everyone, the government is actually applying them only to a certain group. And of course, that certain group is the public servants, the first-rate citizens in Portugal. Those rights, the right to strike of the public servants, was never put into question. In fact, the public servants are the group of people that do the most strikes in Portugal. Their right to strike was never in question. However, the truck drivers, well, they have no right to strike, because the government put into action the civil requisition, which essentially mandates the truck drivers to go to work, even though they are on strike. So this is Portugal. And although I do want to do all the videos about José Socrates, I'm starting to think that José Socrates was not the worst that we've seen. We are actually seeing the worst right now. Because not even during Socrates' time, between 2005 and 2011, we saw things like this. We saw lots of totalitarian-like policies and behaviors, but never like this. At the time, even José Socrates was trying to mask that behavior. Right now, with António Costa, there is no masking of this behavior. They do it in plain sight, and no one does anything. As I said, the media is completely controlled by them, they don't question the government, and the justice system is completely controlled by them. If not for the fact that the judges are all corrupt, they are also getting 700 euros of raise without doing anything. They don't really need to do anything. They get the money from the taxpayer, of course. The taxpayer is funding this raise to the judges. I'm baffled. What happened in the last month in Portugal is baffling. But there's really not much that we can do except go vote and kick these people out of power, because Portugal has little left and they are still destroying that. Anyway, I hope you like this, and I'll see you next time.